Okay, what is 9 o'clock? So good morning once again to everyone. Welcome to school year 2022-2023 K-12 COVID-19 testing program vendor webinar. This is a collaboration between Texas Education Agency, TEA, and the Texas Department of State Health Services, also known as DSHES. And this morning we are excited because we are joined by our partners at Thermo Fisher Scientific. In just a moment, I'm gonna turn over the mic to them. But for some quick logistics, this session is being recorded. And on Friday, once all of the vendor webinars are completed by close of business, we will have the vendor webinars all posted along with the slide deck that they're sharing with you all. So if you want to go back and review it, you will have that throughout the school year. And for those who could not make it today, they will also be able to do that as well. And then lastly, we will have a Q&A session at the end of the presentation. So please drop your questions in the Q&A feature at the bottom of your screen, because we will address those at the end of the session. And this is Thermo Fisher. So please, let's keep our questions pertaining to Thermo Fisher and the testing program. We know that there's a lot of other things going on, but let's just focus there. With that said, I will turn it over to our partners at Thermo Fisher. You all are free to take over.
Thank you very much. Good morning, everyone. And thank you again to the TEA and DSHES organizations for allowing us to continue supporting Texas in the 2022-2023 school year. My name is Mackenzie Varga. I am part of the Thermo Fisher COVID testing team, which we call Ready, Check, Go, which is a partnership between Thermo Fisher Scientific and Keller. Keller Health is represented on the phone by Teji and Eve. Also, my team includes Aurelia, as well as Andrea on the phone with boots on the ground in Texas. So maybe some familiar faces if you've worked with us in the past, but we're looking forward to the opportunity to overview our program for the coming school year. And through that, our agenda is threefold. Just a quick reminder and a quick overview on who Thermo Fisher is, along with Keller Health, and how we've been involved in the COVID response. Then we'll touch on the actual Ready, Check, Go program. What is the program? How does it work? What are some highlights for your review and consideration as you make decisions around a testing program? And then lastly, we'll talk about how do you move forward with Ready, Check, Go should you be interested in partnering with us to support your testing. So kicking off, the COVID-19 pandemic, which is now in year 3, feels like year 20, but it continues to be part of our lives. And there are a lot of statistics that have evolved over the past few years that really we want to highlight and reiterate that Thermo Fisher Scientific has been heavily involved. We are familiar with the pandemic, as many are, and we're familiar with the response that we've done, and we're very proud of that. We have been involved in school testing as well as testing in general across the globe. Specific to schools, we've tested over roughly 1.5 million individuals across both students and staff. So a quick statistic there. So we've been doing this for quite some time for a number of schools, districts across the US. Over 1200 schools have used our testing program, and we are a singular source. So we really can do anything that you need within the testing platform. So a few statistics there. And our key partner in making all of this happen is Keller Health. And together we have created Ready, Check, Go, which is our testing program for schools and other settings as well. So what did we do last year with Texas? A few snapshots to give a little bit of color around what we've done. We work with over 70 districts across the state of Texas, whether it was ISDs or some private schools. So we were very proud of what we were able to help mitigate last year and keep students in the classroom, keep students healthy. We did testing around PCR as well as antigen using labs Mako and Sonic. So two labs helped us run results for PCR testing. We also, as I mentioned, did antigen testing, and I know the state is very familiar with that for two types of tests, the QuidEL QuickView test and also the BD Veritor test. So many of you might be familiar with those, but that is what we were able to do last year, a continuation of this year. How did the state do with our testing program? We had about a 22.71% positivity rate. So you see some of the stats. So we're very data-driven, which is really what the schools need to make decisions. So that is again, part of our program and what we're happy to support the districts in the coming year. A couple things on results for those schools that did use PCR, of course, rapid antigen is quite fast. The result time was about 20 hours, and our range is around 16 to 24. So we're very competitive in terms of getting those results back to the schools to make decisions. So that was last year. And considerations for testing programs have not changed. And so, you know, this is an important part of your decision-making process, what you do, how you decide to do that, things about empowering teachers on focusing education. We don't want the testing program to be difficult or distracting. We want learning to be the primary focus. That was our key and core activity as we designed our testing program, and it remains something that we're very proud of. And our testing program provides that. It also provides easy implementation, where you have extremely a light touch on the software that's providing the results, as well as the products needed to run the test. There aren't boxes of materials, a lot of space that we'd be taking up. There's very quick and small products that we provide to you that make it very easy. And we'll describe those shortly. There's a quick video, which we want to actually hold on sharing at the moment, but ultimately this link will be available. And this shows how easy it is to swap for schools that are using specifically the PCR testing. But again, they're short swabs, they're swabbing that can be done by students themselves, and they're quick and easy to implement. Can you all hear the audio? Okay, so we'll hear this quickly.
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to hold for just a minute because I want to give a chance to provide some information from the color team. So Teji, I'm going to switch the slides. So if you give me 1 minute, and maybe you could do a quick overview around the color team and what you've done with the pandemic response.
Absolutely. Hi everyone, I'm Teji Carney. I'm a partner manager here at Color. I've been working very closely with Thermo Fisher on this Ready, Check, Go partnership since the launch of it in mid last year. So I'm very excited to be here today to talk about our Texas program. As far as Color, so we're a health technology company that's helped about 6,000 schools perform COVID testing and vaccinations over the course of the pandemic. We've provided about 22 million COVID tests around the country, and it's something we're quite proud to be able to help with. We're focused on making sure that all the complexities around COVID are made simple and made easy for you to do, especially in the school setting. We really have worked on finding ways to bring testing into areas like schools, churches, and lots of other non-conventional testing sites. For the Ready, Check, Go program, we'll provide software for your participants to register and receive results, as well as for your staff to collect samples and track results to see positive and negative. The way we see it, we want to make this partnership with you very strong and very, very easy. We know you're all doing a lot, so we're hoping to make it as streamlined and simple as possible. We're excited to kind of walk you through that program later in the presentation.
Thank you. And just give me 1 minute because I want to bring up another part of the presentation that we can share.
No problem.
So just give me 1 moment. We'll get right back to that.
Absolutely.
Okay. So you should be able to see this. And I want to make sure we get to the right section. Which is really about what is the testing program. So the testing program is really three parts, which is PCR individual testing and also antigen. And the on-site PCR testing is something that, again, we did last year that was provided. And it's a pooled test where you can put six swabs into one tube. So we have that available. A little bit of how that works for those schools that are not as familiar. It's really individual swabs and then are going to be collected. I want to show some descriptions of what that actually looks like and what you get at your school. So again, what I mentioned at the beginning of the presentation was you don't need a lot of materials to get this program off the ground. So if you use PCR testing, you would receive a box that would look similar to this, which would have materials inside of it, including swabs, a bag for return and tubes. So individuals would be able to swab their noses, put them into the tubes and return. And all of the shipping materials are also provided, which is on the far right section. And that information is, again, all provided in the same box. There's labels that are already included, so you do not need to worry about printing labels, affixing labels, doing anything like that. All the school needs to worry about is receiving the materials and administering the program themselves. Individual PCR testing is similar, where there's only one result and one sample collected. This is really common and what we used a lot in Texas last year to determine with the most accuracy, which PCR provides, what that actually looks like is one swab to one tube that's run in a lab. And the results are coming through the color platform, as Teji mentioned. And again, our results are within 24 to 48 hours, but from the earlier part of the presentation, we provided those results in about 16 to 24. So we had a very competitive turnaround time for your reference should PCR be interesting. And again, same materials that you would receive at your schools. Antigen testing is the other part of our offering that many of you are familiar with. We all have likely done antigen tests at our homes, and we certainly have supported this in schools. The process is similar where you are swabbing your nose. The process to get the result is a little bit different, whether it's the collection card or the some of our products which have a reader. So we are offering that as well as we did last year. The results also are logged in the color system. So everything is coming back in the same manner with respect to positive or negative results. So how do we actually get started with this program, which is I think what we want to focus on this, you know, for the remainder of the presentation, as well as asking questions that you all might have around our testing program. Again, it's a very easy process to implement. The process to get started is really around three parts. It's getting the onboarding process completed, which is really a very detailed communication plan, which we work in collaboration with the schools to ensure you are educating the parents or guardians around what the testing program is and allowing students to register for testing or staff, if you'd like staffing to be tested as well. So all of that is done electronically, where consent is given from a parent or guardian for individuals, of course, which are most of students under the ages of 18, and giving them a little bit of overview of what the program is. If you're doing testing on a weekly basis or you're doing symptomatic testing, whatever you decide, that's what we would help you communicate to the student and staff populations. We also provide a lot of training through our teams to ensure that you're comfortable with what testing is going to look like, how the results are given. There's a lot of questions around the platform. So Teji and Eve would be part of that, as well as their team, to ensure everyone's comfortable. And then the logistics, including, you know, getting you started, getting the testing materials in your hands, getting any paperwork in your hands that you want to show in terms of setting up a testing station, all of that is part of the program. So those are really the three key areas that we have that exist by way of setting up. So it's really easy to get started. It can be done in as easy as really a week or less, which is kind of a timeline that we wanted to share. And more detailed steps that I've just outlined in the past slide around getting the onboarding set up, the actual setup, who's going to be your touch point at the district? Do we need to complete training? If so, when can we get that scheduled? Where are we going to store the materials? Let's get the materials shipped. Let's get everyone registered. And then after all of those three steps are completed, we're really ready to start the testing program. So it can be live as soon as that point. And throughout the whole process, as well as when you're running the testing program, we are there to support you. We have a dedicated inbox, as well as phone numbers, additional materials. We have a website that will be provided by the TEA resources and on the TEA link, which will be the actual webinar, as well as additional materials that you might want to peruse to understand or raise additional questions to us. We are there to support you throughout this entire process. And again, some visuals that I mentioned around what you can use in your schools. There's a lot of materials to post in the schools to help educate as well as identify where testing is going to be completed. So all of those physical materials can be provided at your convenience and what you think is necessary. I'll turn it over to Teji now to talk a little bit about the dashboard and what that onboarding process and consenting process looks like, so you can have a better understanding of what that all actually means. Teji?
Thanks, Mackenzie. So as Mackenzie mentioned, the registration and reporting and all of that, we try to keep it as simple as possible. We know you and the schools are wearing many hats. We know parents, guardians, staff members have a ton going on in their personal lives. So we just really want to make this as seamless as possible. One of our biggest shout outs on our registration process is that it's bilingual. So our full process is either in Spanish or in English. Something that's amazing about that as well is when you get your results, it will come in the language that you registered in. So once you do it once, it's saved as part of your profile and it's not something you're going to continuously have to toggle through. Additionally, you only need to do this one time. So our registration and consent takes about 5 minutes maximum, and you do it one time for the entire school year, and the parents, guardians, and staff members are all ready to go for the testing. Parents and guardians for their minors, sorry. Mackenzie, do you mind advancing? Thank you. So this is an example of our resulting. So we'll take care of all of that, meaning that we will send it to the participants as they test. We will also send it to the state and do the reporting all for the schools in that way. We'll communicate the results via text or email to the participants. So they'll click on this individual link, as you can see in this picture, and they'll go from there. Again, if they registered in Spanish, this will come over in Spanish. We are completely HIPAA compliant, so there is a bit of a confirmation that you need to go to once you click on that link via text, just to make sure you're the correct recipient of that text message and that result. Thank you. So as Mackenzie said, we're here to support you in every way that we can. In addition to Thermo Fisher, we also have a support phone email that's around 24/7. We have, for the participants, we have a line that you can call to answer any questions you haven't seen a result, if there's any concerns around your consent, anything like that. But most importantly for the schools, we have a ton of training for the people on staff that are actually doing the testing. We also have flyers, materials, different things that you can give to, you know, people to make them, help them understand what the program is about, get them excited about it. We also will offer you ongoing trainings and office hours to ask questions as the program continues. We don't want you to feel like we're here in the beginning. We're here all the time. We're here weekly. We did webinars last year, if you were part of the program, weekly. So we're looking forward to doing those again. Just to be here to support you again, we know that there's a ton going on, and we want to make sure that this is just an easy thing in your day and not a slowdown. So that's a pretty high level from the color end, but I'll turn it back to you, Mackenzie.
Thanks, Teji. So again, reiterating how easy it is to register, consent, and also the results come in a very efficient manner. So hopefully some of you on the call have spoken to other districts or had direct interaction with those that have used the program and can attest to it. And to continue that, we have a lot of positive feedback, some of which we're sharing on this screen, to really talk about our experiences and the positive results for students as well as staff, parents, and more stakeholders that have been impacted by COVID testing. It's hard to find someone that has not. But whether it's, you know, talking about how easy the swabs are to use, the support from our teams and the testament to that, the availability, how easy it is to implement. Just a few snippets to share here to give a little bit of confidence to you as you consider what you're looking for implementing for your programs in the coming year, which has really kicked off. So we're quite there. And just to reiterate, where do we go from here in terms of us allowing us to help you and serve you? We certainly want to field any questions during our session today. We want to share the resources that exist around getting started, whether it be the link that you see here, the links that the TEA team will send out. Of course, the TEA COVID testing site is a very detailed resource to provide links to this presentation, the presentation that we did back in June, as well as other general information around the testing program. And then, as Teji mentioned, we have done in the past, which was very successful, weekly office hours to support just ad hoc questions or more focused questions that you might have, maybe hear from your peers at other ISDs looking to ask questions. So we encourage that, and we'll certainly be sharing some specifics around when those will be kicking off for your engagement, should that be of interest to you. And then lastly, just we want to thank you for your time. We know that the beginning of the school year is an incredibly stressful one, getting back into the groove after summer, and hopefully a restful summer for all of you. And unfortunately, COVID is still around. So having the ability for us to support all of you as you consider how are you going to implement testing and what testing looks like for you is something that we are all here for you around. We want to support that, and we want to field any questions you might have at this point. So again, thank you for your attention, and we will turn that over to the TEA team for any questions that are coming through the chat or otherwise.
Thank you all for your presentation. And then also to my colleagues at Dishes, Diana or Anika, if you wanted to add anything, please feel free. We do have one question from Barbara Seeger or Sager. It says, if you were in the program last year, yes. So, it says, do you need to re-register this year? So I'm going to answer this on a TEA side. You do need to reapply. All school districts this year, public or private, regardless of your application or participation status of the last year's, you have to reapply. Now for Thermor Fisher, I'm not sure if they're talking about registering for color or so forth. So I'm not sure how that works.
Yeah, the color team can maybe take that one since there's been some updates, so they can share here.
Absolutely. So if this is in reference to a participant, you do not need to re-register if you plan to test at the same site. So if you're a teacher and you're testing in the same place, you do not. We do have a consent that might expire, and you'll get a two question box kind of notification when you go to test, but you won't need to re-register. The only time that that would be necessary is if you're either changing schools, changing sites, or let's say a child is going from fifth grade to sixth grade, meaning that they are now moving to a different school, they'll need to re-register in the new school.
And this
thank
is
you for that clarification.
This Go is ahead, Diane. And so just another additional question. I'm not quite sure, maybe Barbara can chime in and make sure that we answered her question, but is there a re-registration that the person that's conducting the testing has to re-register in the color system? That may be what she's asking, not as a participant or a patient being tested, but sure, the person who's conducting the testing.
Thank you, Diane. Yes, again, if it's the same site as last year, no. You are set, your permissions are set, you're ready to go for this year. If you are moving for any reason, we will need to update that, but it'll be the same.
Any other questions?
Yes, please feel free to drop them in the Q&A feature, or if you want to come off mute, yeah. Yes, color registration was my question, thank you. Okay, so she's good to go there. And then training-wise, I think you all touched on it. I'm actually sure you did. But I know you have the office hours, but if someone needs the training for color, they just reach out to you all and they'll be trained by you and so forth. And then the continued support is with those office hours, correct?
That is correct. So you can reach out to us. We'll set up a training for the team anytime they need to do any of the walkthroughs and help with any of those questions. And then ongoing, yes, we'll have weekly webinars that Mackenzie showed on the last slide.
Gotcha. Perfect. Diane, I'm not sure if you or Nico or anyone from Dishes wants to add any context, because we get emails quite a bit and Dishes gets emails. So I don't know if you all wanted to bring anything else to light while we have this time.
Yeah, maybe so. Mackenzie, did you want to go over your pricing of your products and your offerings?
Yeah, I'd rather have the link to the TEA training or the TEA page reflect that, just to make sure we're all talking about the same thing.
Okay.
But we can, I know that's updated there. I will highlight that the main change from last year for those schools that have engaged is correct. And this is a comment. We are not offering staffing this year. So Eva, thank you for that comment. Yes, that is correct. We are no longer offering staffing. So that is the primary change from the 2021-22 school year. That's the primary change. Diane, I think, has a comment as well.
Oh, no, I don't have a comment.
Okay. It said you wanted to answer it live, so I wanted to make sure you had
you did answer it live, so then I moved it.
Okay.
I'm going to share my screen really quickly pull up the vendor resource sheet that Mackenzie referenced.
Sure. I want to make sure that it's, you know, I want to use your sources to make sure that we're pointing everyone to the right location and they're familiar with what they're able to see. So.
See my screen? Is it vendor resource sheet up?
Yes.
Perfect.
Yep. So just to walk everyone through this, again, there's two primary offerings, which one is PCR testing and one is antigen testing. So of course, if we scroll down, you have a lot of information here that some of the districts I'm sure have all seen. We have specifically, I'll wait till there's movement. So I want to make sure we're all looking at the same thing here.
All right, I had to enable editing. Sorry about that. Okay, there we go.
No worries. So column G is Thermo Fisher Scientific for those that are online and can see this, of course. So there's a lot of detail here. I know everyone has likely perused this page to ensure that they have detail. I'll touch on the rapid antigen details again. There's two primary offerings. There's the BD Veritor test, which is $20 per test. And there's the QuickView, the Quidel QuickView, also $20 per test. There's some minimum orders. This is how the quantities come. So just a quick note on that. And then there's also a couple details on how long the results are there. So you'll see that information. For the BD test, there is a analyzer that's required to run the results. So the cartridge is placed into the analyzer for those that are familiar. And that's $350 for that analyzer. So it's really a companion part to the test. Our team can answer any questions if you have specifics. Some schools have used that in the past. Of course, that'll still be applicable there. So again, we can answer specific questions around what the details are. But those are two primary antigen tests, the Quidel QuickView and the BD Veritor. BD Veritor requires the analyzer. So those are comments there. And then if we scroll down to PCR, there is a couple flavors of PCR that are part of our offering. One is the individual PCR. So that's one swab and one tube for one result. So John Smith comes to the nurse, says, "I'm not feeling well." The nurse swabs the nose, or the child swabs their nose, whatever the setup is for if there's a nurse on staff. That is sent to the lab. A result is provided in that 24-ish hours. And that is $48.50 per test. If you want something more economical, and there's a number of people that are getting tested at the same time, this is more, I would say, in surveillance testing or asymptomatic testing, which we do at a lot of schools to determine what is the population of positive students across everyone. We have a lab pooled test, which is, again, John Smith swabs his nose, puts his swab in a tube, and then five tubes, so five kids potentially are testing at the same time. At the lab, they put the results together and they run them and they determine, is there a positive, and so who it is. So it's cheaper to do for schools if you have a higher number of tests that you're trying to run. But again, the process is still the same for collecting that sample, one swab and one tube sent to the lab. So those are a couple of details. Again, turnaround time, the anterior nasal is what we're using, again, the short swabs. And again, both of those offerings were part of our program last year. So for schools that have worked with us in the past, it's going to look very similar. The primary difference, again, that was raised is we are not offering staffing. So we cannot deploy people to your schools to help run the program. Hopefully that answered the question around pricing, Diane and team.
Yes, thank you very much, Mackenzie.
Sure. And again, the TEA website is the best source for all of this information. The team keeps it updated should there be any changes for Thermo Fisher, as well as the other vendors engaged in the program, as well as links to our presentations, our resource materials, and so on. So it's a great resource. It's that one-stop shop. I know there, you know, when we launched the program last year, there was a lot of questions. TEA and DISHES were instrumental in helping to navigate those questions collaboratively with us. So we expect the same process to happen, as well as other resources that are needed to launch program testing for this year.
Thank you. Thank you, Mackenzie. I love your website shout out. Thank you. Thank you for being a cheerleader there. Thank you. Just to add on to that, and then we still have some time left, so you can feel free to drop your questions in there. Any questions that you might have along with the vendors, all of that, we have the FAQ and guidance documents that all list here, tools and templates. The vendor piece, the vendor resource sheet is here. It was last updated on August 4th. If there's any more updates, we will update this. Diane is really good about updating this over at DISHES. They send it to us and we post it. Your allocations are here. So once you've applied and your name will appear, and then you'll know if you're able to order tests or what, you know, staffing and whatnot. That wouldn't be with Thermo Fisher, but you would be able to know if you're ordering tests and how much money you have there. The application is here, other resources. And then at the end of the week, you'll see under recordings and presentations under this webinar and presentation subheader, you'll see right here, we will list all the vendor webinars along with the link to their slide deck. So please check out, as Mackenzie so wonderfully articulated, please check out our website. We update it very frequently. We try to provide as much resources so that you're not always having to email and wait on a response. You can just go here and see what you need. You're free to email, but we've tried to do our best to support you all and support the vendors by putting the needed resources here for you. So that website is here. So thank you again, you all, for highlighting that. I'm gonna stop sharing now. Any other questions, please let us know. And just to reiterate, if your name does not appear on the allocation sheet, then you would not be able to order tests just yet. But once it appears, you're free to reach out to vendors based on your allocations. And they look at that allocation sheet to know who is eligible to receive tests or not receive tests. And if there is an issue or discrepancy, email us. We try to resolve it within that week, if not sooner, because we know you all need the test. Please continue to drop your questions. We'll leave a little bit more time. And then if there are no more questions, we won't belabor the time and just hold people, but we still wanna create some space, because we won't be doing, as of now, another vendor webinar this school year. Okay, well, I don't see any more questions. Diane or anyone else, did you have any last comments or anything you wanted to bring up?
Nope, I don't think.
Okay. Well, thank you all for supporting partners with us, supporting TA and DISHES, supporting public schools. Thank you to everyone that's attended. Please be on the lookout by Friday, by 5 p.m. for all of these things to be posted, to go back and review. And as Thermo Fisher and Color, some folks have said, they have great customer service, so being on screen, we can also directly reach out to them. Thank you all. So that is it. We'll go ahead and conclude today's webinar. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.